Good evening, ni hao, namaste, and salamat patang. My name is Shireen Adeshir, and it is my honor to be your host at today's iconic launch event, which marks a new partnership between Singapore and India through the establishment of Singapore Institute of Management, the global education's first overseas teaching center at Garodia International College. Let us mark this special occasion with the lighting of the lamp. This collaboration, Mr. Nishant Garodia, Managing Director of Garodia Education, Mr. Ian Davis, Dean of Garodia International College, Ms. Trucha Vatsa, Country Manager for Singapore Institute of Management, Global Education. Today, this team is also joined by Mr. Carmen Teo, Regional Director for West India Enterprise Singapore, to commemorate this occasion. Let's have a round of applause for them. I would now like to invite Mr. Teo, our guest of honor, to offer some opening remarks to the event.
Hi, Mr. Nishant Garuda, Mr. Ian Davis, Ms. Trisha Vasta, distinguished guests. Very good evening to everyone. It's an honor to be here, and I'd like to start by thanking Garuda and Singapore Institute of Management for inviting me here. To witness the launch of this partnership. As you know, Singapore and India share a deep and multifaceted relationship between our government, businesses and people. And the partnership between leading education institutions like Garodia Education and Singapore Institute of Management is another good example and milestone for our deepening Singapore-India relationship. This partnership launches the first SIMGE Overseas Teaching Centre in India at this campus. And SIM and GIC will jointly run this program, provide students exposure and to a global pedagogy while allowing them the flexibility to complete their higher education in SIM Singapore campus. Against the backdrop of a constantly evolving environment, it's important to remain nimble, and this partnership will afford the students the options and flexibility to prepare them, preparing them for the next phase of their education. I would like to congratulate the good work done here and look forward to fruitful returns from this partnership between Garuda and SIM. And finally, I wish everyone a pleasant evening. Thank you.
I request Ms. Trucha Vatsa to come on stage and join Mr. Teo. And on behalf of Garodia International College, may I request Mr. Nishant Garodia to offer the felicitations to our Singapore representatives.
Thank you.
Request Mr. Nishant Garodia to come on stage. Mr. Garodia is known for establishing progressive institutes that have played a significant role in shaping the future of education in India. Through severe perseverance and innovative ideas, he has spearheaded institutes that focus on developing the overall personality of students. With an in-depth understanding of emerging technologies, Garodia Education Institutes, under the leadership of Mr. Garodia, have employed methods that make learning fast, easy, and an interesting process for students. I would now like to request Mr. Garodia to share his vision.
It's a pleasure to welcome Mr. Carmen Teo from Enterprise Singapore, Ms. Trisha Agasta from Singapore Institute of Management, India Rep, for this launch of the Singapore Institute of Management first overseas center in India. I also extend my welcome to my privileged guests, representatives from the media, friends, colleagues, and my dear students. Today, standing in front of you here, it makes me feel proud for such an important occasion of Garodia Education. Garodia International College, as we know it today, started as an offering for Broward students as a place to further their education. Today, not only do we offer liberal arts in Broward program from Broward, but now we are launching for the first time Diploma in Management Studies offered by Singapore Institute of Management Global Education. This, my friends, is just the beginning. I am hoping to offer many more such options at GIC and more prestigious universities at this campus. We are traditionally known for our prowess in K-12 education, having been in the field for 52 years. GIC was established to make international undergraduate education accessible to more students in their own backyard at affordable cost. These programs offer the best of international education with no compromise in quality. I hope this small step in higher education sphere for Garodia Education would lead to offering probably the degree from our campus, and maybe, just maybe, the college will become a university someday. With this ambition and dream, I wish the team a very best for our future endeavors and would like to take this opportunity to thank all those who have made this possible. Mr. Ian Davis, our Dean, Dr. Amar, Ms. Nanette, Team Study Networks, Sohil, Sushmita, Priyanka, Sukrina, everybody from GIC team marketing and digital. I would be failing if I did not mention about one person who laid the foundation for GIC in the formative stages, who was not only instrumental in signing the Broward, but put the college together in its current avatar. Right from the name of the logo, name to the logo and the look and feel. That was Deepal Garodia, my wife. She's not in the country, but she gives her best. Good luck, God bless, thank you.
I would now like to invite Ms. Trisha Vatsa to come on stage. She advocates transnational education while heading the country office of Singapore Institute of Management in India. Prior to SIM Singapore, she has held several senior management positions with the University of Leeds, Middlesex University, and the Navitas Group. I now request Ms. Vatsa to introduce SIM Global Education and the partnership with Garodia International College.
Thank you, Shireen. That was a lovely introduction. Mr. Nishant Garodia, Mr. Ian Davis, Mr. Carl Meng, Very good evening, distinguished guests, members from the press, members of the Garodia Education Group, staff and students and parents of the Garodia family. Truly feel very honored and privileged to be here today at the launch of the very first overseas teaching center of Singapore Institute of Management in Mumbai with Garodia Institute International College. I think we should all give a big round of applause for GIC on this. We are blessed to have had initiated this partnership with Mr. Nishant and his team, because the whole process was so seamlessly trouble-free and hassle-free because of his vast experience and the vast experience team that he has, Mr. Davis and his staff members and faculty members. It was a very rigorous and the process was very cumbersome because we represent a Singapore entity, and we understand, Mr. Karl Meng would vouch for that, how Singaporeans work and they go by the rule book. So it has been a long journey. We went through a lot of paperwork and everything was like foolproof and everything was so positive, and this is the outcome. Today the first OTC is being launched and we will have students studying at GIC the first year of SIM undergraduate program. So the certification would be awarded by SIM, called the Diploma in Management Studies, and after the successful completion of the Diploma in Management Studies, GIC students would be progressing automatically to Singapore Institute of Management, Singapore, and they will pick up their second year UG degree, a choice of their degree. So with that, I will do a bit of a presentation. So I will maybe quickly just explain a bit more about this educational scenario in Singapore, a bit on the SIM, and a bit on what opportunities the students really are going to have in terms of this partnership that SIM and GIC have forged together. So, someone has to click the slide for me.
You have to click.
Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you, Ian. So, here we go. In terms of studying in Singapore, yes, because I've been in the industry for so long, I have worked with several universities, with British universities and with Australian universities. But the best part about working with Singapore universities are students and parents are so calmed about the fact that Singapore is such a safe nation. It is very affordable to pursue your higher education there compared to other higher education destination. And also about the smart, high-tech city that it is, well-wired city. People are so friendly and everybody again goes by the rule book. There is no, you will never find anything called eve teasing happening in the campuses, or you will never hear that your children are facing problems like ragging is unheard of, eve teasing, or any street issues. Nothing happens. Everything works by the round of clock and everything is so seamless. So that's one comfort. And because Singapore is hardly like five and a half hours away from Delhi, from I think from Mumbai it's hardly 4 hours away from here. So again, the fact that it is the proximity factor really helps the parents and the students and everybody else who would like to take up their higher education in Singapore. They're very comfortable with the fact that they are just few hours away from their homeland, and if something happens or if an emergency happens, they can just fly down over the weekend. Like Carl was just mentioning me, just sometimes he feels like taking a holiday. He just goes over to Singapore over the weekend and comes back and joins his work on Monday. So that's a big comfort level that we have when we send our children to a country which is so close by, so safe, and has actually the world standards in terms of imparting education. I am very sure all of us have heard about the National University of Singapore and Nanyang Technological University. So these are the premier public university that the country boasts of. But of course, they have very stringent entry criteria, so not everyone can make it to these public universities. Therefore, we as private education providers come in the picture. And SIM, I'm very proud to announce today that we have been recently declared as EduTrust Star Certified Institute. So EduTrust Star Certification is very important because it is the highest level of certification in terms of provided by the regulatory authority CPE Singapore. So which means the achievement and the how we work, the way we manage and administer is all commendable. So very happy that EduTrust Star Certified SIM has joined hands with another very reputed entity in India, GIC. Moving on to a little bit about what children really want is, of course, other than the fact that the country is so close by, the kind of the very reputed and international degrees that you can actually get in a very affordable cost is very attractive. So students do look at the fact that these are recognized and globally recognized degrees. Also, the course fee, the cost of living, the campus life does attract, because as I said, children will never feel that they are lost in some wild campus and there's nobody to look at. There's a lot of hand-holding that still goes on in most of the Singapore universities. So some of the students and parents actually like that environment. Coming from the Indian mindset, they prefer that children, when they are at 16, 17, 18, they should be a bit sheltered, and they get that kind of campus environment in our universities and institutes. Culture-wise, again, there's absolutely nothing to worry about, because there's such a smooth transition that happens culturally. It's an Asian country, so nothing like I'm trying to settle down or I'm trying to acclimatize myself to the environment. Language-wise, again, children face no issues. Everybody speaks in English. The cab driver will also speak in English. Everybody speaks in English in Singapore, so definitely, absolutely no issue with the language problem. And the kind of exposure that you get there, because Singapore is having these kind of international collaborations wherein they invite globally recognized university from US, UK, Australia, France, and these universities come and teach their program in Singapore campus, the children truly get this sense of global exposure that we talk about. So it's not that they're only getting the Asian flavor, they also get taught by British faculties, by renowned public universities like the London School of, under University of London, we have LSE, Goldsmith and UCL. All of these are partners of SIM, and the faculties actually fly down to SIM Singapore and teach partially. So that's the kind of exposure, global exposure that the children get when they are there to pursue their further education. Moving on to, talked about it. Yeah, so most of the universities, like it is a very standard way of internationalization of education, actually talks about giving maximum global exposure to our students. So you will find most of the universities, and I will talk about SIM in specific, we do have arrangements where a semester or an entire year or the entire 2 years, you can actually move on to your partner university that is awarding the degree. So let's say, for example, we have a partnership with the State University of New York, Buffalo, Sunny Buffalo. The program is such that, let's say the child starts here at GIC, the first year, 15 months of diploma is over, he progresses to second year in Singapore, and he pursues the UB degree, the Sunny Buffalo degree. At any point of time of his studies in Singapore, he can seamlessly seek a transfer to the New York campus UB. And that's the kind of exchange program and transfer feasibility which makes the whole program so attractive. So global exchange opportunities are available, and we have these arrangements with University of London. Students can do 4 to 6 weeks of summer school at LSE. And then we have with University of Birmingham, where students can actually go to the Birmingham campus for 2 semesters while they are studying their second year and third year in Singapore after finishing the diploma year here at GIC. And then the similar arrangement is with Stirling, RMIT, Buffalo, and Wollongong. That's the exchange opportunity that I talked about. So yes, children also have this very interesting arrangement where they can take 1 year at LSE, and when they come back to SIM for the final year, again the credits are, the academic credits are transferred. So it's a very interesting way of actually learning and teaching, where students starts in India, goes on, moves on to Singapore, does 1 year there, goes off to LSE, finishes another year, and then comes back, and all the credits are accepted and transferred to each other, and he finally gets the degree awarded by the University of London, London School of Economics and Political Science. So this is one student from, Anshit was actually from Mumbai a few years back. He went on to finish his economics and management degree from University of London, LSE. He did 1 year at LSE. He came back, the credits were transferred. Similarly, I'll just skip through quickly because we are running short of time as well. Buffalo, we also talked about as to how the exchange semesters are possible. Even the full year transfer is possible. So if the student wishes to completely transfer himself or herself to the UB campus in the final year, it's allowed. And the best part is about the international exposure. When I was talking about 60% of the faculties actually fly down from the partner university, Sunny Buffalo, and teach the program themselves. So the student gets this feel of the true way of the real way, you know, how the American faculties teach, their methodology and everything is replicated there. Similarly, University of London. Highlight about the University of London LSE programs are children who are actually wanting to make a career into banking, finance, insurance, accounting. They should, after finishing the diploma here at GIC, they should then move on to the second year and accept the University of London bouquet of programs, because this will, you can see the host of programs, they are all related to accounting, banking and finance. Sterling talks about few programs. There's a specific program called Sports Studies and Marketing, which is run at Sterling. So the same process is everywhere, that you start the first year here and then move on to the second year and third year. Likewise, we have RMIT and Wollongong from Australia, La Trobe from Australia, offering tourism and hospitality. So in a nutshell, you will see we are kind of ensuring that the student, after finishing the common first year of diploma in management study, gets to do the second year in either accounting, banking, insurance, business management, sports studies, supply chain, logistics management, tourism, event management. All the programs related to social sciences, IT and business are available. So the choice factor is very, very attractive here. The children actually get to choose which degree he finally wishes to do after finishing the DMS, the Diploma in Management Study at the Garodia campus. We do have scholarship, which we can talk about it later when the student comes to Singapore. Yes, there are definitely academic scholarships available, up to $15,000 merit scholarships are available. There are about 40 awards, so all the GIC students will be eligible to fight for those coveted $15,000 scholarships in their second year and third year. So that's it, and I'm actually very, very happy that the first OTC is functional now, and we can feel the vibes here. So many people in attendance today, and it's really, really very prestigious for us also to have been tied up with GIC, and the start has been so good. So let's hope, as Nishant was mentioning, that this is just the small step, first step towards collaborating and forming the first overseas teaching center. Let's see, it should lead to having SIM campus actually coming in to the Garodia campus in the future years. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much.
I request Mr. Davis to talk about the collaboration between Garodia International College and SIM Global Education.
What an exciting time to be here as the head of a group in India. I think that India is one of the most exciting places to be educationally in the world currently. Not only is the government opening its doors to external people to come in, but it's embracing the idea within its own national curriculums of international perspectives, critical thinking, and thinking outside the box in general. And I like to think here at GIC, we're ahead of the game. We're a real nugget in offering opportunities to our Indian students and families at an affordable price to really take opportunities that are going to allow them to become some of the world leaders in the future. I genuinely believe that, and I think the opportunity is there to be grasped. So I think that this partnership has the opportunity to change the lives of young people for the better. We have a lot of experience here that's been laid by Garodia International College and Garodia Education. We're not new in this game, and I think that should give you some confidence in who we are. And we really do believe in acting as a stepping stone for Indian students. And it was so beautiful on those videos to see Indian faces, Indian students. The opportunity is genuinely there. We are not creating something brand new. We're already on a pathway that exists for the young people here today. So we have a long history of community innovation. We're a community enterprise, and I think we're going to be a community university in the future as well. So it's our pleasure, and it's honourable for us, and for me particular, to be associated with SIM. I don't think that Ms. Tricia actually gave real credence to the awards that SIM has won and international recognition that SIM has won. You're quite humble in your approach, I think, and thank you. But I'm going to not be humble, because SIM really is one of the outstanding institutions that Singapore has, particularly in fields of business management, computing, technology, and all of those areas. So it's a wonderful opportunity for us. And to give that progression to a master's and possibly a PhD is quite an amazing opportunity for young people. So we're very proud to be associated with SIM. Essentially, as Ms. Trisha said, students will do 15 months here, and then they will top up the rest of their degree from between 1.5 to 3 years on an undergraduate program from where they choose. Pathways, as you've seen, lead overseas as well as to Singapore. It's a unique opportunity. We've seen some of the universities that we have partnerships with, and I can see that you can recognise that at least three of them there are in the top 20 in the list of universities in the world. That's amazing. That's quite an incredible achievement for SIM to have those partnerships. And these partnerships are now starting here in India. That is the significant thing from today. Just to give you a flavour, it's a very well established course. We're not trying to create things that have not been established, tried and tested in the past. So over the 15 months, the modules are pretty much based around a core of business management, and they're recognised here and around the world. All of the materials come from Singapore, they come from universities that they're in association with, and all of our students have full access to their library and facilities and everything that's required to be successful on this degree in the end program. And what I think is unique is the way in which this is going to be taught. It's really a genuine 50-50 partnership. Singapore lecturers will, and guiding lecturers from overseas as well, they will deliver lead lectures, and they will give sessions on the latest research at the start of each of the modules and at various points in the program. And then here on site, our Indian lecture staff, who have been approved by SIM, and from some from visiting Singaporean lecturers as well will come, and they will deliver practical sessions, workshops, and the variety of assessments that support, explain in greater detail, and really explore the conceptual nuances of these degrees and these modules. So it's quite a unique program, because we're getting the established academic framework, and we are able to give the personalised support and development that many students don't get at huge universities all the world over. And I'm going to emphasise that again. Our students will be getting a personalised support and development second to none and better than most. Right from day one, our students are registered as part of the Singaporean experience. They're not registered here as an Indian diploma. It is genuinely a program from Singapore. So they will be part of that network from day one, and they will be associated with all of the opportunities that are given to the students wherever they may be residing. Who are we looking at? And I think this is where we really are being quite innovative here and quite revolutionary. This is not a program for the traditional academic elites of the IB program, maybe the A-level program. We are genuinely looking for students from all of the state boards and national boards because they produce fantastic students. And we want to give them the opportunities that go with their fantastic abilities. And so we are really looking for a wide range of students and to apply for this course to come in our first program. What do they need? Well, quite simply, students and families who wish to gain the advantage of an international curriculum so that their future lives are bettered, I think. Students that want access to top universities by their final degree, through their good scores. And perhaps it's going to affect them positively in their future careers. No, perhaps is the wrong word. It will affect their career potential in a positive way. The figures are quite interesting. The average starting salary that I looked up for graduates from this program is quite reasonable, I think, to begin with. And that's because they're going to their bosses and they're going to their future employers with a global exposure. They're going with different cultural understandings and with a CV that is very attractive because they're bringing that collaboration across cultures and across different groups. And that is something which enterprise in India needs definitely for the future. And they've got practical experiences they can talk about. It's quite easy, in a sense. We're not making it difficult. We want some of the best students that we can get. And so the application is through filling in the application form, submitting the 10th and 12th final mark sheets, a passport copy, and yes, a minimum of 60% in the 12th grade. That's recognising the talent that is in India. Most of the students who haven't applied already are higher than that, but we know that this program, with our kind of support that we can give, will benefit many people. Raising the opportunities is what we're about here in India. And our facilities are second to none, which is why SIM came to us to start this partnership. For those of you not visited our campus, then please do at your leisure, but take it from us, with some of the pictures here. We have state-of-the-art Wi-Fi laboratories from Germany, a learning centre, specialist design studios, even a Lego innovation studio for those that wish to play around with Lego still. And I'm sure that some of the degree students have already asked me, can we play with the Lego? And of course, if it's connected to their course, yes. We've got the large underground hall here for sport as well as concerts. And they will have all of the opportunities, special opportunities to indulge as they wish in a full life outside of the classroom. And yes, we have a very nutritious cafeteria on site. So to summarise, there are real economic advantages for this course. People who come onto this course are not going to be charged at the same rate as if they're in Singapore. It's affordable. So, to conclude finally, I would say in India today, we really should look long term. We are looking what's happening in the world, and it's now a world of opportunities. We're post-COVID, touch wood, but we know how to cope with something if that occurs in the future. Education must not stop. And really, students need to ask themselves, families need to ask themselves, where do you want to be in 10 years? Because the decision that you make today, tomorrow, to come and join this program could affect you seriously where you are in 10 years in a good way. When we know that our graduates nowadays have at least 5 different careers in their lifetime, not jobs, different careers, we know that providing an opportunity like this is an essential one. So Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming. We hope that you are quite excited, because we are, about the opportunities that we're offering, and we look forward to prospering with a partnership, not just with SIM, but with, from everyone who's seated here in the audience. Thank you, everyone, and I look forward to having our first cohort of successful students.
Distinguished guests, parents, and students. My name is Celia, and I'm the Assistant Director for Student Recruitment Group in Singapore Institute of Management. I am very excited to be working with Garodia International College. Garodia International College, GIC, is our very first overseas teaching center in India. This partnership is very significant to SIM as we look to provide the opportunity to more students seeking for studying overseas. We have been through a long discussion and evaluation process with GIC before the appointment. I am very glad to have GIC as a partner, as we can see GIC's commitment to academic excellence and providing a holistic education experience to all students. This is in line with SIM's vision of being a learning partner of choice for every learner. To be the learning partner of choice, we seek to collaborate with a partner who holds the same ideal as us. SIM is selective in appointing our overseas teaching centers. We went through a rigorous process evaluating the campus operation, students' administration process, student development, faculty interview, and the outcome of GIC past graduates' performance before we decided to work together. The journey of appointment is just the beginning, and we will continue in a joint effort to ensure both parties work together closely to continue our quest in bringing opportunities of quality education to more people in India. Success breeds success. GIC has produced credible student outcomes through its collaboration with Broward College, and we trust the Institute to continue leveraging on its experience in offering overseas programs towards the SIM Diploma in Management Studies. The program will be jointly taught by both SIM and GIC lecturers, whereby SIM will be supporting 50% of the teaching online, and GIC will be supporting the offline classes. SIM diploma is equivalent to the first 1 to 1.5 years of a university degree and provides advanced standing to QS top ranking university degree programs. For instance, the University of Birmingham, that is ranked as one of the QS top 100 universities in the world. Upon completion of the diploma with a credit, students will be able to embark directly into the Year 2 Direct Honours Business degree. There are also many other options, including the University of London, RMIT University, and La Trobe University from Australia. Students will also have the option to complete an American degree that is awarded by University at Buffalo, SUNY. I am very pleased to share that SIM has been awarded the EduTrust Star Certification effective 20th August 2022. According to the EduTrust Certification Scheme criteria, the EduTrust Star Certification is accorded to private education institutions for attaining a commendable level of performance in managing their institution and providing an outstanding quality education and welfare for their students. It is also a symbolic recognition for outstanding achievement in our field of work. Lastly, I would like to congratulate Mr. Nishan Garodia, founder of Garodia International College, on this partnership. Thank you for your support and your belief to bring this excellent opportunity to the community in India. My appreciation also goes out to all at Garodia International College who made this collaboration possible. We certainly look forward to working closely with you, and I look forward to meeting all of you and hope to welcome you to Singapore soon. I wish you a very successful launch, and I wish I could be there, but I'm not able to. So please enjoy the day, and thank you very much for your time to attending this event today.
Share my heartiest congratulations to the Garodia Education and SIM Global Education teams and wish them all the success in this new venture. I would like to request the audience to once again join me with a round of applause.
We'll fly, all fly.
now thank everyone for making today possible. Garodia Education and SIM Education Global teams who have worked tirelessly over a year to make this opportunity possible. Special thanks to Mr. Nishant Garodia, Mr. Ian Davis, Ms. Trisha Vatsa, our guest of honor, Mr. Carmen Teo, who took the time out of his busy schedule to be present here today, and our audience here, our esteemed principals, counselors, industry partners, alumni, parents, students, and media, for being a part of this launch ceremony. The ceremony is now concluded, but the conversations are just getting started. So with that, may I please direct you to the buffet outside and encourage you to meet and interact with the team that has presented here, as well as with each other, to know more about how this partnership can benefit you, your students, and how to take the message forward as well. Thank you so much. Thanks.
We all know with the new NEP policy, the government is furthering higher education in India. Now, we need more universities to come up in this country to offer opportunities to our Indian students who have been wanting to be on the global scale. So this partnership gives them an opportunity to be able to do something with an international qualification very much in their own country, in the safety of their home and at affordable prices, maintaining the quality which is there in international. So it's a small step towards offering them more education opportunities in the country itself.
I think this is a unique opportunity here in India, which is so exciting in current times. Firstly, we're bringing world-class lecturers from all over the globe, UK, America, Australia and Singapore, delivering their lectures and their experience and expertise to Indian students. And then we bring them here to offer the workshops, to understand the concepts, and to really give a personalized education that never been seen before. So I think we've got a unique situation where the young students of India are going to gain huge advantages for their future, especially when they go to an employer. They're going to be able to say to them, hey, I work with the top lecturer in the London School of Economics, University of Birmingham, Buffalo, or even La Trobe or in Australia. What better can they do? The employer is going to look at the student and say, I want you. Thank you very much. Can we have more students from this centre as well, please? So that's why it's going to be unique. It's going to give our students the chance to broaden their experience and their profile.